Hi, everyone.
Well, this is it. This is our final lesson for Clubhouse for the year. Quick, go and grab your Bibles. We're going to need them shortly for our sword drill. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, you are the one true God that we can all come to and trust in and learn from and know that we are loved. So we ask that you help us tonight to hear again, one more time, what it is you want us to hear so we can live the life in you. Amen. We have been sitting at the feet of Jesus this past year, listening to him speak to us from his Sermon on the Mount. It all began when Jesus called some ordinary men to him and said, "Follow me." Jesus then spent time teaching these men about himself so that those men would be able to go out into the nations to teach other people about him. In October of 1997, Jesus asked me that question, "Will you follow me?" And I said yes. Well, I didn't say yes. I was crying, just heavy tears, and I knew I needed to give my life over to Jesus. And why did I do that? Because I believe Jesus is King over heaven and earth, that he is powerful, that he has everything that I need. He has all the answers that I need in my life. And I believe that Jesus died on the cross, rose again, and he paid the debt for the penalty of my sins. And I believe that following Jesus is the best life that you could live. This is where we're going to do our sword drill. So grab your Bible. Bring it up over your head. It's Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. And say it with me. Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. Ready? Go. All right. Read along with me. "I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. The life I now live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me." Living a life as with Jesus as Lord is just like springtime. It's just like it is right now. You know, it's been a long, long winter. And now that spring is here and the rains are coming and new life is happening, that's what it is. When we give our life over to Jesus, a new life begins. He makes us new. It begins like this acorn. See my little itty bitty acorn? This acorn starts out as a tiny seed and it grows into a mighty oak tree. And just like this acorn, we will grow in our relationship with God. Isaiah chapter 61, verse 3 actually says, "They will be called oaks of righteousness, a planting of the Lord for the display of his splendor." And God gives us everything we need to grow in his kingdom. God sends his Holy Spirit to live inside of each person who puts their trust in Jesus. God's Holy Spirit gives us the power to know right from wrong. The Holy Spirit gives us the power to do what is right and to say no to what is wrong. We are not alone. When we give our life over to Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit is with us. There are a few things that we need to do in order to get to know God. Read your Bible. This is God's love letter to you. This is no ordinary love letter. This is alive. God's word is active. It is powerful. What we also need to do is we need to talk to God. Spend time praying to God throughout the day. Anything and everything matters to God. What matters to you matters to God. We need to be still and listen. Jesus said his followers will know his voice. When my great nephew was born, I actually helped watch him for quite a while so that his mom and dad could go to work. And there was one day when I noticed something. We had some family members at our house and everybody was talking. And then when I would say something, my great nephew would turn his head towards my voice. He knew my voice in a crowd of people. And that is what it is like for us. When we know Jesus' voice, we will hear him over others. So the more you read his word, the more you pray to God, the more you be still and listen for his voice, the more you will know him. Another thing we need to do is obey God. We all know what obey means. But I have a song for you, so do this with me. A little O, a bigger O, a great big O. One, two, three. O is for obey. O is for obey. Obey is doing what you should. O is for obey. Every time we choose to obey, we grow a little closer to God. Back in September of 1990, I had the opportunity to go to Alaska for a week, and I fell in love with the land. It was so beautiful up there. And I said, one day I'm going to be back there. And then over the years, Lakewood Evangelical Free Church sends a team of people to Alaska to Echo Ranch Bible Camp to help the camp prepare for summer campers. And every year I'd pray, God, is this my year? God, can I go to Alaska? And I'd get a no. Next year I'd pray again when the time was announced, God, is this my time to go? And I'd get a no. And then just this past February, when the dates were announced for the trip to Alaska, and I prayed, oh God, is this my year I get to go to Alaska? And I got a yes. I could have gone any other time if I wanted to. That's not the way I wanted to do it. I wanted to obey God and go when God told me to. And so that's why I prayed and I was obedient to his answer. Well, then COVID-19 arrived and everything changed. The team to Alaska should have been there today. Right now, I should have been in Alaska helping prep the camp for summer campers. I am not questioning God as to why he had said yes and then it became a no. Lamentations 3:23-24 says, great is your faithfulness. I say to myself, the Lord is my portion. Therefore, I will wait for him. I am waiting on God because I want to be obedient to God. Let's go back to this little acorn. If I planted this acorn today, would it be a giant, mighty oak tree in a week? No. It would take years for this to become a mighty oak tree. But even over the years, every day it would be growing more and more and more. And for us, when we read God's love letter, when we spend time listening to God in prayer, and when we are obedient to God, you will see that every day you grow more and more and more in your relationship with God. Now go and live a life in Christ. Let's pray. Your word, O God, is mighty and powerful and active. Holy Spirit, we are so thankful that you live in us to teach us and to guide us to what is right and what is wrong. And so we ask from everything that we've been learning from the Sermon on the Mount that we can go out and live the life in Christ that you are calling us to do, growing every day closer and closer to you. Amen. Have a great summer, all of you, and we'll see you in the fall.